Hello and welcome back to another Beginner's Python Challenge. To complete this challenge, you should write a program that accepts the sequence of words. So like in other tutorials, let's just utilize the terminal, utilize the Python input. So this sequence of words, it doesn't have to be separated by commas. We can just use spaces, so just write a sentence, for example. So what we're looking for here is to return a sorted list of all the words that are entered, whereby all duplicate words have been removed. So we're going to return a sorted list of words that were used in the input, but we're going to try and remove all the duplicated words. You may already be familiar with some of the different built-in data types in Python, for example, a list, tuple, and dictionary. Something that doesn't get much exposure on courses and tutorials is the use of Python sets. So like a list, tuple, and dictionary, a set is one of the four built-in data types used to store collections of data. Assuming that you're familiar with lists, tuples, and dictionaries, a set is a collection which is unordered, it's unchangeable, and is unindexed. And that's important to understand if you understand the other data types in Python. So to actually create a set, it's really simple. Sets are written with curly braces. So you may already be familiar with curly braces because we've been utilizing them to create, for example, dictionaries. So let's say x equals, and then this time we just say a, b, and c. Okay, comma, c. There we go. So this is a set. So we can go ahead and just print this set. Let's see what the outcome is. Oh, that's not going to work. And there we go. Now notice that the input here was ABC, but it returns CBA. Now if I run this again, notice that the order that it returns is always a little bit random. Of course, not true random, because that doesn't necessarily exist, but we're just talking, you can see visually that it's in a different order every time we return a set. Of course, we can check to see if we are actually utilizing a set. So let's just use type here to see what type of data we're working with. If we return that, it tells us we're using a set. So how is this relevant for this challenge? Well, if we take a look at an interesting property of a set, if we were to duplicate one of the items here in this set, in actual fact, it won't return any duplicates. So if we return this, you can see it returns C, B, and A. It doesn't actually return the additional A. So if I add something here, for example, D, it should return D, but again, it won't return any duplicates. So we can utilize this property of a set to answer this challenge. So let's go ahead and create an input so the user can type in a string, a sentence, and we'll grab all the words. So we use x split. So we use splits. That's going to then take the words that were inputted and convert that into a list. So we want to define the separator, which is just going to be a space in this case. Maybe you want to have the user enter words separated by commas. In this case, it's going to be just a space. So we're going to split the words via the space, and then we can go ahead and print off our list, which is going to be sorted. So let's sort this list. That was the idea. And we are working with a list. So let's define the list here. And now what we can do is we can return that list, which is sorted. But what we want to do, obviously, is to avoid any duplicates. So this is where we can nest a set. So let's take our words, pass it into the set here, and then that's going to return all the words minus the duplicates. We then convert that into a list. We then take that list, we then sort it, and then we go ahead and print it off. So that's how it's going to work. So let's just give this a go. So we're going to be asked for the input. Hello, how are you today? Okay, good. So I'm avoiding any commas here, etc., because I haven't built that in. So there we go. So what we have here is a list of all the words that we utilized. But notice that I tried to add some duplicate words here, and you can see that they've been removed. So that was duplicate words aimed around introducing Python sets. If you haven't already started to utilize them, or if you weren't aware of them, hopefully that was the case. Thank you very much for listening. If you do have any other suggestions on how to complete this challenge, then please leave them in the comments. It's always good to see your suggestions and to share that with the community. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.